Hey guys, Paul here from Kelso Cooks. Today we're going to make a very simple homemade banana ice cream recipe. Now all we're going to need for this is two ingredients. We've got our bananas and we've got some honey. Now we all have bananas around the house and often they go turn black. And 9 times out of 10 we throw them out. Because you know, they're not that appealing to look at and especially kids wouldn't like them. So there's no real excuse for throwing out good food like that. So the best thing you can do is to peel your banana. Okay. And then what we're going to do is just chop it. So we're going to chop it just into half inch slices, roughly. And then what we do with that is we put it into a storage container. And then we pop our storage container into the freezer. And once the bananas are frozen, I'll show you then what to do with that. Okay, so I have my bananas all chopped. As I said, put it into a storage container. Pop the lid on. And what we do is pop those in the freezer, let them freeze. Anything 3 to 4 hours will freeze your bananas. But I mean, you can do this any time in advance, pop them into the freezer and keep them there until you're ready to use them. So what I have here then is some bananas that have been frozen beforehand, okay? Now take them out and leave them about maybe 10-15 minutes just to let the room temperature get to them and they slightly soften so that they can easily break apart on you. And what we're going to do is pop them into the blender here. Okay, so we're just going to pop our bananas in. Okay, they'll still come out in chunks like this. Just break them up as they go in. And there's been 3 bananas that was in this container here. Okay. Bananas away. Now, into the food processor. And we're going to turn this on and we're going to whiz it until it becomes nice and creamy. Okay. Okay, halfway through, you just want to take the lid off and just with a spatula, run it in around the edges just so none of the bananas stuck to the edges. Well, you can really get that banana-y smell coming up through there. Now, cover it back on. Okay, so you can see there our banana ice cream is starting to become really smooth, okay? So what I'm going to do is we get our honey and I'm going to turn it on again. And we're going to drizzle in roughly about a tablespoon of the honey, just to give it an extra wee kick of sweetness. Okay, so our ice cream has come to a nice creamy consistency. Okay, so we just pop this off. And we take out our blades. Okay, so I mean you can have this straight away, it's slightly soft, but if you didn't want to have it straight away you can obviously put it back into the freezer again, wait till it hardens up again and then have it as normal ice cream. But for the purposes of this, we'll just take out 2 scoops here in each bowl. And then if you want you can add some toppings. And you're talking proportion here, you're talking roughly about 130 calories. I mean, that's nothing for a nice little bowl of ice cream, you know. Then, as I say, you can have anything you like then on top if you want to add. We've got chocolate chips here, we've got chopped walnuts, we've got marshmallows, whatever you like yourself. And just to mix it up, put some chopped walnuts in one. And some chocolate chips on the other. As I say, the choice of toppings will be completely up to yourself. You can also add in, if you wanted during the mixing stage, some peanut butter. If you want a nice wee kick of healthy fats into it and a bit of protein base. But there you have it folks, we've got some beautiful homemade ice cream. And bar the chopping and the freezing that you'll do at some other stage, I mean you can see yourself that's ready in a matter of moments. Okay, and it's a really healthy alternative. I mean you can have it plain. Or say add a few little toppings like that, but it really is a healthy alternative, especially for kids. And you know, after dinner on a Sunday or something, you just want that little bit of sweet kick, little bit of dessert. That there is just absolutely perfect for it. Okay, thanks for watching, and on YouTube remember to subscribe, and I'll be back with more video recipes very soon. Thank you.